If there was ever a funny parasha, which is in Hebrew, a paragraph, is in this particular one. I mean, here we see a few things. The first thing that we see is that Abraham doesn't believe God. He just doesn't believe God. Here he sits in Mamre, and four people come there. And they tell him that your wife is going to be pregnant next year when we come again. Now let me tell you something, and here I'm talking to women as well as to men, but mostly to women. At that age, women do not have children.
Don't want to.
Let me say it again, they don't have children.
Amen.
They don't have parents. They just don't have children. So what does Sarah do? She does what most women do. As she listened to this, she sat in her tent, and these angels asked Abraham, where's your wife? I'm surprised they even asked that question. And they said to him, well, she's in the tent. And he said, oh yes, I can hear her in the tent. But what is that noise that I hear? What is it cackling in the tent from there? And they said to him, this is her laughing. She's laughing. Because she thought to herself, at my age, you expect me to have a child? Now, I don't know who you are. If you're really an angel, then you better convince me some more. But if you're not an angel, then that is really the biggest story, I would say a full story, that I've ever heard in my life. And looking at you, Dodo, Mr. Abraham, you certainly could never child. Not at your age. Not at your age. I mean, look at us. I don't know if they had mirrors in those days. But if they did, she must probably say to him, come, let's get into the tent and look at the mirror and look at ourselves. Do you really believe that we can still have children? So he went into the tent and he looked at himself. And you know, man, I've got ego, so he looked himself and said, well, maybe, you know. I'm a big angel, you know. Maybe. But this one? How could it possibly happen? I mean, she must be 70, 80, whatever her age was, but she looks 120. Of course he didn't say that to her. He was a gentleman. So he walked out and he went to his servants and he said to them, take the best sheep that you can find and cook it the best way that you know how. And then prepare the best meal that you have ever made up and give it to these men. So my question when I read this was this, was it because they told him that he's going to have a child? Or was it that ego that was in him? But whatever it was, he was very, very happy to have a child. So, a year later, and you know, when God says something, he doesn't tell stories.
That's right.
He tells the truth.
Yes.
Exactly a year later to that day, the same angels came, I'm sure, and by that time she was pregnant. And by that time she had a child. I must tell you, when I read this, I laughed too. But yet, it was the truth. It was the truth. Family, when we read that book called the Bible, I can assure you, everything in it is the truth.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Let me say it again. Everything in it is the truth.
Hallelujah.
And everyone who does not believe it today will one day say, we never thought that these people are telling the truth. But there it was. There it was. So she had a child, and the happiness in that household was the greatest that you can ever think of.
Amen.
I mean, let's face it. Not only the miracle in it, but to have a child.
Amen.
To have a child, folks. For men, we bozos don't know what it means to have a child. And the reason is very simple. Because we are cowards. If we had one child, every family would only have one child. We cannot take pain. We cannot take pain. If we knock our femur or something, boy oh boy, you can hear the screaming three blocks away. Because we're cowards. And I can prove it. Women live longer than men. Usually. Women can take pain more than men.
Amen.
And then again I can prove, and so can you. But men still think that they are the machos. And this is why God created man with these muscles, you know. So everybody could see that they are the macho man. But as life goes on, you can see that the macho goes away, slowly, slowly. It really does. It goes away. And women overlive men. They do it so easily. So easily. Because they have got that way from God. God created women to be stronger than men in every way. every way. So here we had the story that Sarah had a child at that age. I'm sorry, I cannot help but laugh. Because when I look this way, and I look at Sheila, and I think to myself, at her age, to have a child, no way in the world. But then I also look at myself. And like I said, I'm a macho, macho man. Maybe. But I promise you, there's no maybes there. No maybes. When I look in the mirror, I can tell you, no maybes.
Hallelujah.
Who said hallelujah?
Mercy.
No, I just want to agree with you. Anyway. The Bible is so wonderful. In fact, it's more than wonderful. It's dutiful. It tells us things that we couldn't believe. We couldn't believe. And yet they are true.
Amen.
And we should believe them. And the reason I'm saying they are true, because who knows? You might have an angel coming to you in your olden age. Believe it. Believe it. Because it might be God Almighty Himself.
Hallelujah.
It might be God Almighty Himself. So therefore, believe it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
And I'm not only talking to the ladies here. I'm talking to us, all those.
Amen.
Believe it. Because God is a faithful God.
Yes, He is.
Amen. God is a truthful God.
Hallelujah. Yes.
God is a God, when He says something, He doesn't just say it because He had nothing to do that day. He says it because He believes it and He wants us to believe it.
Amen.
I mean, does it make sense to you?
Amen.
Man, that was a shout. Does it make sense to you?
Amen.
Praise the Lord, somebody agreed. For a moment I thought, that's it. God is a truthful God.
Glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He's a truthful God. Yes. Because if He wasn't a truthful God, He wouldn't be God. He just would not be God. The reason that He is God is because He is truthful, He is righteous, and whatever He says, you can believe.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Believe me, I could have made it funnier if I wanted. But believe me, after reading it, I realized I don't have to make it funnier. It's funny enough.
Amen.
And I wondered to myself when I read it, how did the people in those days react when Abraham told them, my wife is going to have a baby, my wife is going to have a baby. And they looked at each other, the guy is nuts. He is nuts. How could he even think of it like this? Oh yes, you people, you don't know. The angels told me. What angels? There were just a couple of people. What are you talking about? What angels? Oh, this man that came to the tent. And I knew right away there were angels. So I said, let's wash their feet. Let's give them the best food that we have.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Because I knew they were the real thing.
Yeah. Amen.
Yes.
How many of you know when somebody comes to you and tells you something that they are real people?
Yes.
Hallelujah. And not just anybody that comes and tells you something.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, yeah.
I want to tell you something. I do, and I'm not anything special.
Mm-hmm. But you can tell.
Even though my wife thinks I am. But when people tell you the real thing, then you know that it is the real thing.
Amen.
So like I said just now, when Abraham told the people about it, they laughed themselves sick. They went to their tents and immediately called their wives and said, listen to this. You're killing yourself laughing. If there was anything crazy in this book, this is it. Come on. I don't know, maybe they had a prayer meeting that evening. And they all sat together discussing the craziness of Abraham. To tell you the truth, if I was living in those days, I would have laughed with them. But one thing I must say, and that is the truthfulness of Abraham.
Amen.
He was a man who believed God.
Glory.
He was a man who recognized if it was a godly thing or just anybody that told him this.
Amen.
I mean, why would anybody come to the tent from nowhere and tell them such a story? Why would he do that? And yet, he believed.
Amen.
Family, I want to tell you something. When you hear something straight from God, believe.
Yeah.
Believe.
Hallelujah.
Because God will only tell you the truth.
Hallelujah.
God will never ever, listen to this, never ever have better things to do than telling you untruths.
Right.
He's a truthful God.
Amen.
Today, we're living in a time, I would say, a time where we ourselves don't know anymore if we are hearing the truth or lies. Listen to what's happening outside. One state is raining, the other one is hot. The third one, there are earthquakes. And the fourth one just quakes anyway. The financial situation is bad. Boy, oh boy, is it bad. Work is hard to find. Absolutely crying. Crying. But you know what? The truth is still there.
Amen.
Amen.
And I'm telling you, whatever you hear God's word. You hear His word. Why? Because His word is truth.
Yes.
Glory. Hallelujah.
And He will never, ever lie to you.
That's right.
Never, ever. Therefore, I can only say to you, my dear family, believe God.
Yes.
Believe God.
Amen.
Amen.
I've been preaching His word for years.
Thank you.
And I can tell you for sure, for sure, that whatever He said came to pass.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Whatever He said came to pass.
Yes, Lord.
As our pastor said, those people that were sick, He healed.
Amen.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Those who needed healing will still get the healing.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
I was paralyzed for 7.5 years. And I can tell you this much. God healed me.
Hallelujah.
In a most amazing, amazing way. This is why I can trust Him. This is why I can say, Lord, I trust You.
Amen.
I'm still not 100% well, but I trust You to be well.
Hallelujah.
And the best is yet to come.
Yes. Amen.
I was so happy to hear about the couple who just came from Israel.
Thank you.
Amen.
Why was I so happy? Because firstly, this is my country.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
But secondly, because they felt it in their heart.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes. Yes, yes.
They walked in places which the Bible tells us about each one of them.
Yes.
And none of them is a lie.
Amen. Amen.
Father God, I come before you in your holy throne.
Thank you.
And I ask you, Lord, to fulfill every request, to fulfill everything that is in the heart of your children. Help them, Father God. Help them, Lord. Yes. Let them know that you are the healer.
Yes, thank
you, Lord.
Let them know that you are the one that can do everything.
Yes, Lord.
Through and by your Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Father God, I thank you so much. I thank you so much for your holiness. Be with us, Lord. I pray for everyone that is here and that is not here. If he's got anyone in his house that is not well, that is sick, heal them in the name of Yeshua, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Heal them. Let them know that your word is the truth. Let them know that your word is the one that comes directly from your holy throne. Father God, I pray for every couple that is at the moment in times of, let me put it this way, that at this moment are in times that are not so easy for. Heal them, Father God.
Yes,
Lord. Heal them. Bring healing to these times. Oh, Father God. For all those people that are here and not here, that need to take pills in order to get better, to get well, Father God, bring it to a time where they will not need them anymore.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Heal them, Lord. Heal them, Lord. Touch them. I thank you, Father God. I thank you. Because you are the one that can do it. You are the one that will do it.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Yes.
And like your promise to Abram, I pray that you will promise to many, and your truth shall come to pass. Let me just bless you with the Aaronic prayer. If you can all stand up. Yevarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha. יאר אדוני פניו אליך ויחונך. יישא אדוני פניו אליך וישם לך שלום. May the Lord bless thee and keep thee.
Hallelujah.
May the Lord shine his countenance upon thee. And may the Lord be gracious unto thee and give you peace. Shalom.
Shalom.
Peace that surpasses all understanding. Father God, as always, I pray that this week will be the best week your children ever had. I pray, Father God, that every promise that you have promised your children will come to pass this week. I pray that every hurt that your children have, just give it to them. Give it to them. Let no harm come to them.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
But let them know that whatever you promise will come to pass.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
And to this we can all say,
Amen.
I know that we have got some noshes there.
Noshes,
something to eat. It's a Yiddish word. And for all of those that don't know Yiddish, we have a class in 2 hours. And after the noshes, we are going to have a Torah study.
Yes.
And if you've never been to one, believe me, you will be blessed.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
You will be blessed. Because you might hear things that you've never heard, learn things that you've never learned. And you will be blessed.
Hallelujah.
I promise you. Have you got something that you want to say?
If there's anybody that needs prayer for healing or for deliverance or for anything at all, please come forward and we'll pray for you. We'll anoint you with oil because it's part of our service. So we thank you and God bless you. And we'll close.
Yeah. Also, if anybody wants to be baptized and receive the precious gift of the Holy Spirit, please see me after the service. Please.